there any truth that, you were in?
You were in the Band Aid recording, but standing at the back and we couldn't see you.
yes.
Where are you in the running order tomorrow? What time are you going to come on shivering with fright?
We're on about, well, I say about, it's got to be pretty exact from what I'm told. It's going to be about 17 minutes past two.
Mm. It has to be. It's a revolving stage, and if it isn't, the stage turns. And you go.
If we're not finished by 17 and a half minutes, it will go back again.
That's going to impose enormous strain on you, isn't it? Enormous mental strain.
Well, everybody's got to do this, because I mean, there's so many acts on, and the organisation is so terrifying that it's got to happen like that, really.
Incidentally, we have a flash of news for you, Bob, so I've just held up a card. China is taking 4 hours of the show.
Oh, great. I was just talking to him, we'd know in a minute. That's brilliant, because we heard 2 hours ago that Russia was taking all 16 hours without any delay, because usually the Russians delay it to see if it's kosher, and they're taking the lot, and we're getting a band in from Moscow in return called Autograph. That's great. So now they're not only going to have a party in Siberia, they're going to have a party in Datong.
And they're going to be seeing you, of course. Nick, how did you get persuaded? Was it the persuasive person himself?
It didn't take a lot of persuading. I mean, I don't think anybody's actually said no to it.
I'm sure they haven't.
Well, I bumped into him at the airport.
Yeah, at Heathrow Airport. I was doing something for a daily newspaper. And Bob was there, and he just said, it was pretty tentative at that stage, wasn't it?
I said, I think it's July the 13th, and he said, okay.
Well, I'd hope that Spandau Ballet would be able to join us as well. Unfortunately, rehearsals, as we heard, are running a bit late. So I have to talk to them via the satellite. So the
pretty flash,
isn't it? Yes, that's the satellite across to Wembley.
Good God!
Yes,
amazing.
I failed that audition as well.
Yeah, you never dodge your air, Terry. No.
Bob, have you any instructions for them, just in case by the time you get back to Wembley they've made some excuse and left?
Well, I hope they change their clothes. Look at them.
We knew we were going to be on the Terry Wogan show.
I'll be back down in half an hour anyway. So see you then.
Yeah. All right. So you've dressed down for my show, have you, fellas?
Definitely.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. Right. Well, thank you for joining us and taking time off from rehearsal, and good luck tomorrow.
Pleasure. Cheers.
Thank you, Spandau Ballet. What's going to happen to you next? Have you thought about that? I mean, are you going to go back to leading the Boomtown Rats? Are you going to go back to be
That's what I like doing. That's what I get satisfaction from. And this is, as I said before, an aberration in my life. And I'll go back to doing what it is I think I'm better at anyway. And I'll have some fun then.
What about the entrepreneurial streak that has now been shown in you?
I always had it. I don't know. You know, I just do things that interest me. I'm motivated by boredom. And as soon as I get bored, I go off and do something else, you know.
What motivates you, Nick? Not the money. Don't tell me it's the money.
No, it's Bob.
Bob is the main motivator. Have you any last minute worries? Anything that's nagging in the back of your mind that you fret about tonight? Toss and turn.
No.
Or nothing you'll admit to me anyway?
No, there's nothing really. I can't see it now. At the beginning of the week, there were a lot of things. It's now all running on course, and it's underway now. So that's it. Like, all these people suddenly come out the woodwork, and they're doing their jobs. And you just sit back and watch them, and you enjoy their professionalism. And you, a rank amateur amongst them, so can sit there smiling and say, oh, well, it worked.
When it's finished, of course, you'll have to go back to being your usual cocky self.
Yeah, it's a complete and utter pain in the neck.
Thank you, Bob. Bob Geldof, Nik Kershaw.